Hi dear children, welcome back to our computer class. How are you all? I hope all are good and safe. In the last class, we learned how to create a new style, isn't it? Did you watch the previous videos? Did you study that portion? I think so. Today we are going to the next topic. Okay, let's start. Next, spelling and grammar feature. When we create a Microsoft Word document for other people to read, it is important to spot and correct any spelling mistakes or grammatical errors we have made. We can let word spelling and grammar checkers suggest corrections automatically while we work, or we can check the spelling and grammar in the file all at once when you have finished writing our document. Microsoft Word 2010 comes with a dictionary of standard grammar and spelling, but they are not comprehensive. Commonly, there are two mistakes highlighted with a different color, namely, a red line depicts that it is a spelling mistake, green line depicts that it is a grammatical mistake. Okay, documents contain two types of errors, that is a spelling and a grammar mistake. That red line depicts it is a spelling mistake. Green line depicts it is a grammatical mistakes. We can check the spelling and grammar mistakes by using different steps. Okay, using the spelling and grammar feature, we can correct our documents. Okay, yes, which are the steps to check spelling and grammar mistakes? The first step is open the document. Here I am going to misspelled the word computer. Okay, yes. Can you see that? For that, first you open the document in which we want to apply spelling and grammar feature. Click on the review tab. Which tab? Review tab. This is review tab. Click on review tab. Click on spelling and grammar button in proofing group. The proofing group, this is proofing group that contain one option, that is spelling and grammar. Click on spelling and grammar button. Okay, a spelling and grammar dialog box will appear that contain different options, that is ignore ones. Okay. First you listen about this, that is first one is ignore ones. Ignore ones means it will skip the word without changing it. Okay. Ignore ones means skip the word without changing it. Ignore all is same as ignore ones, and also ignore all other instances of that word in that document. Okay. Yes, ignore all is it will skip the word without changing it, and also skip the word the other instance of that word in the document. Next is add to dictionary. We can add a new word to the dictionary. Okay, yes. So it does not come up as it is an error again. Next is change. Then that means you can select the new word from the suggestion list. Then click on change. Then change all. That means that word will change in all in the document. Okay. Now I am going to select a word from suggestion box. The first one is computer, compare, compare. Then which word you want? Then you select that. Okay. I am going to choose computer. The word computer. Then click on change. Okay. After that, click on close. Computer. The spelling and the grammar check is complete. A message box will appear. Then click on OK. Now, the spelling of computer is correct. C-O-M-P-U-T-E-R. Computer. Okay. Got it? Yes. And what is ignore ones? What is ignore all? Ignore ones means it will skip the word without changing it. Ignore all means to skip the word without changing it and to also skip the other instance of the word in that document. Okay, that's all. This is the spelling and grammar feature. Okay, dear children, today it's enough. Everybody should study nicely and watch these videos again and again. Thank you.